Despite a lifetime of heart issues, Lisa Casper has the optimism that comes with hitting a remarkable milestone. This year, the Arlington woman celebrates 30 years of life after a heart transplant at age 21 at the University of Minnesota Medical Center. It's a length of time that none of her doctors promised. One even told her to expect far less.
I remember at age 30, I had a doctor who said I would never make it to age 40, and I kind of would like to talk to him right now.
Casper, who will be 52 in October, was born with a bad heart. It was twisted and pumped backwards. She saw a cardiologist when she was 6 months old, and at age 10, she had open heart surgery to replace a mitral valve. She was a 21-year-old newlywed when she got sick enough that her doctor told her she needed a heart transplant.
I remember thinking, oh man, I don't feel so good. And out of breath, retaining a lot of fluid, tired. I went to the university just to see what was going on. And they says, yeah, your left side of your heart is going downhill very quickly.
After a lot of thought and financial planning that included her husband Troy and parents Gary and Patty Duncan of Flandreau, she decided to pursue a transplant.
My husband and I had nothing. We ended up having to sell everything we owned, pretty much.
Her insurance company eventually covered the transplant, but at first the company wasn't sure it would because it had never had a request for one before. Financially and otherwise, the hospital needed to be assured she was making a decision that she could stick with for the rest of her life.
Because it is a commitment. It isn't just the battle isn't just gonna be fought today, it's gonna be fought every day.
In December of 1989, Casper moved to the Twin Cities to live with her aunt so she could be close to the hospital when she was matched with a new heart. Casper clearly remembers the day she received the call.
Going to garage sales was our thing. And I was picking up a puzzle at the time, and my beeper went off, and I had now have done that and framed that. It's my lucky puzzle, but my beeper went off. I had to go call them to confirm that it wasn't a false alarm. They told me to come to the hospital.
It was Friday, July 13th, 1990. She was getting her second chance at life, and 2 days later would become the 236th person to receive a heart transplant at the university, a number that has grown in the 30 years since to more than 900. The recovery process was long and difficult. She was in a coma for a week and had a long hospitalization.
It's such a trauma to your body to go through that it just takes a long time to kind of get into things. Even at being age 21, it still took a toll.
These days, Casper runs her own custom tarp making business in Lake Preston. She's never had an issue with rejection, takes 10 prescriptions a day, and has an annual medical exam where doctors look at the function of her heart. She tries to eat healthy, avoiding salt and fat. Her work doing industrial sewing keeps her active and busy.
No, the doctors I have right now are really positive and work really hard at longevity. And I remember coming home and told my husband that he better start taking better care of himself because I could outlive him. I know that I don't really have long-term goals. Like I never really have set myself, okay, let's do a 5-year plan. I kind of live day by day. Let's see what happens.